Welcome to the Toffee Blues, your source for all things Everton, and welcome to your weekend edition of the Everton 24/7 Daily Report. Well, tonight we're leading with the name which popped up in the summer and has popped up again in January, and it's a name that any Everton fan is familiar with, and that is because his name is Everton. Everton Suarez, to be exact, and yesterday the Brazilian paper Gazeta Esportiva suggested that Carlo Ancelotti has held talks with the Brazilian attacking midfielder who shone last summer at the Copa America. He scored alongside our very own Richarlison in the final. The suggested fee by that article is €30 million. And of course, from a marketing perspective, this could be a stroke of genius. Not to mention making commentators lose their marbles when they're covering our games, which would be absolutely fantastic. But from a footballing perspective, it would also be a very good move. I think Everton is your typical Brazilian player. He's full of flair and trickery, but also looks as though he has an aggressive side to him and a physicality needed to cope in a more intensive league like the Premier League, and a similar weight to Richarlison himself, just a little bit smaller, but he's a very, very gifted player, so it'd be great to see if we could pull that one off. Safe to say, I'm very much still behind the prospect of Everton playing for Everton. A few other rumours now going round over this weekend. Everton are reportedly interested in signing Inter Milan midfielder Matias Vecino, according to top Italian journalist Gianluca Di Marzio. However, it is rumoured that Vecino is holding out for a switch to Tottenham instead as part of a swap deal which would take Christian Eriksen from Spurs to Inter. No doubt Vecino will be an upgrade on the present midfield options that we have with Andre Gomes and Baman still out injured. But this story does beg the question, should we be trying so hard to pursue a player who is holding out for a move elsewhere? In my opinion, we do need to start pursuing players who are 100% sold on the Everton project and are prepared to give 100% for the cause if and when they arrive here. And if Vecino isn't that player, then we need to look elsewhere because we can't have, to be quite frank, half-arsed performances. And we've seen far too many of them over the last couple of years. And if this player isn't fully committed to the cause, then it's not the right move. Moving on, the Newcastle Chronicle have suggested that Everton are after young Newcastle goalkeeper Freddie Woodman. He is currently on loan at Swansea City. If anything is to come of this, it would most likely happen in the summer after he has completed his season-long loan in South Wales. However, Woodman is keen on getting some first-team football, and it's hard to see whether he has it in him to dislodge Jordan Pickford. If that does happen, though, what a rivalry it would be for our number one shirt. Just rest assured, the last thing Jordan Pickford would want is to be usurped by a Geordie. And finally today, a bit of a negative story, actually. An article in The Athletic yesterday suggested that Bayern Munich could look to sign our very promising youngster, Anthony Gordon. They did suggest that while a potential loan has been considered, Gordon will not be sold. He now stands a good chance of featuring under Ancelotti in the first team as the season moves towards its close. And for me, I think the time is most certainly now to give Gordon his chance, not just because we risk maybe losing him, but also our midfield options are limited. We've not been playing so well, and that seems to be our weak point. And despite getting the win we needed yesterday, I think it would be a real benefit for us to move forward by having Gordon at least on the subs bench for the rest of the season. Hopefully that becomes the case. But that's that for the weekend. Be sure to let us know your opinions on all the topics of today. Give us a like, a comment, and a subscribe. Of course, there wasn't much in fairness today. The big focus of this weekend, the past 2 days, has been our win against Brighton, and maybe that's why the rumour mill has taken a back seat as we covered all areas, really, of that win. And thank God we got the win. But rest assured, they're preferably back up to their old tricks again tomorrow. So make sure you tune in for the show tomorrow night when I will be back. And until then, thank you guys for watching on the Toffee Blues.